Director Frank Capra was quoted to have said, "There are no rules in filmmaking, only sins. And the cardinal sin is dullness." He also forgot about plain sucking at your job. Enter the self-proclaimed greatest indie filmmaker in the world, Tyler Ultra 7 Sebert. This is a man of little talent. Along with his lifelong friend and one-man camera crew, Richard Cornell, Tyler Sebert holds the record for most flops at the box office. Let me just read you a few of his titles. Oh boy. I Was a Teenage Hormone. Wasn't that a riveting film? Who could forget the masterful China Shoes of Wood? I know I can. Eat, Sleep, and Die. The Story of Life. And of course, his latest bomb, El Tomato. A Spanish documentary on a dear hombre, the tomato. Or tomato. I don't judge. Even I'm shocked that Tyler, whatever his fucking name is, producer Vincent Polk, hasn't slit his wrist over all the money he's lost. But maybe, and just maybe, there's a chance he'll make one good film. A film that'll prove to the world he's not some kind of filmmaker wannabe. Yeah, right. And I didn't do Lucifer for the paycheck.
Jimbo, Jimbo, I promise you, baby, selling out to Carmen Fernetti will be the greatest decision you could ever make as a producer. Have I ever lied to you? I didn't think so. So, is this a deal? Excellent. Consider Norbert Industries officially mine. Pleasure doing business with you, Jimbo.
Oh, I'm good. Industries is all mine. Oh, alrighty. Who's next on the chopping block? Let's see. Vincent Polk. Well, Vincent. I haven't talked to him in all ages. Ages. Let's bring the bastard up.
This is the biggest pile of shit I've ever read in my life. Fair process my ass. Judy! Cancel my subscription to the Harvard Business Review! Polk, speak.
Vincent, old friend. This is Carmen Fernetti. You know of Carmen Fernetti Enterprises? Yes, I thought you'd remember. How are you doing, old chum?
Fernetti? I haven't heard from you since boarding school.
I know. It's crazy how shit happens. We grew up as roommates. The future tears us apart. You go off and become a rich man. And I grow up and become a powerful individual.
Yeah, real funny how that kind of stuff works out.
It's great to hear your voice, Vincent. It really is. I always missed our late-night hijinks.
What the hell do you want, Fernetti?
Ah, I see you're a man who likes to cut to the chase. Wise you are. You see, Vincent, I've become a person in the world who likes to take charge and bring smaller companies under my wing, per se.
Are you calling me a small company? Okay, I'm not a huge, massive conglomerate like your ass, but Jesus, I produce films, for fuck's sake.
And may I remind you who you produce films for?
I've seen a couple of them. Let me look at it. Ravenous Turtle People. Maze of Windows. El Tomato? Not exactly A class, Vincent.
Still, it's a higher class of stuff than what you're doing. What do you own now, like 6 porn production companies?
Really? I help fund smaller companies to become larger companies. in hopes that they can reach their full potential.
Uh-huh. Sure you do.
I'd like to extend a healthy hand of gratitude towards an old friend and help them. Join me, Vincent. Come underneath my wing, and you can become the businessman you've always dreamed of.
What's the catch?
No catch. All you have to do is give me the rights to your company.
And there it is! There's the bullshit that I've been smelling this whole time. You fucking con artist!
I beg your pardon?
Oh no. I've read about people like you. You build them up with pretty words, promise them the moon, and then you yank the whole damn company out from under their feet and leave them hanging out to dry.
I'm afraid you're mistaken.
Oh, I'm mistaken. Okay, so let me ask you this. Where exactly do I fit in this great corporate vision of yours?
Give you a side job is all.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Listen, asshole, Vincent Polk does not work in a fucking cube farm. He runs his own damn company.
Look, Vincent, I didn't want to get brash here, but listen to the real news. The indie world is dying quickly. Smaller industries need to be bought up by the real conglomerates, so we can do the right.
Oh, the right work. Do tell, what is the right work?
Cleansing the world of untalented filth.
Hang on, are you calling my crew untalented, you Italian fuck?
Listen, either you give me the company, or you'll suffer the consequences.
Look, listen, douchebag. They may be untalented hacks, but they're my untalented hacks. And they will continue to be my untalented hacks until I say otherwise. As a matter of fact, Judy! Give me the world's smallest violin so I can play for my old friend Carmen Fernetti here. Polk out! Asshole.
Shit. If I don't buy all the companies on this list, I won't meet my quota. I need to sink Polk somehow. Wait a minute. If he doesn't have a film crew, he can't produce any films. I have an idea. A dark and twisted idea.
All you viewers who aren't akin to the Filmmaker Wannabe legend, this here is the little brother to infamous drug kingpin Maurice C. Big. About 3 years ago, he had a run-in with Tyler Sebert, and let's just say, it didn't end well for Mr. Big. I guess Leon here hasn't found out about his badass older brother yet. I hope it stays that way.
Your phone is ringing! Pick up your phone! The phone! Yeah! The phone is...
Listen, your brother is dead. He was killed in cold blood by a couple of filmmakers named Tyler Sebert and Rich Cornell. The Filmmaker Wannabes.
Ah, shit.
Man, where the hell is Rich?
Tyler Sebert?
Who the hell are you and what are you doing on my set?
Hi, I'm Alex, the cameraman, and the front door was open.
You're not my cameraman. I already have an official cameraman. His name is Rich Cornell.
Right. Rich is sick. He had a family emergency, and the indie crew sent me in as a temporary.
Oh, well, that's really unfortunate, because Rich is my best friend.
But I brought my camera with me.
So. Oh, yeah, sure. If you're a temp, I'm sure you're great with that, but this is the official camera, so let's shoot the scene. All right! Let's go! Come on, everybody! Let's get ready!
What are we shooting?
Let's go!
Yeah, let's do it. Action.
That's my job!
Cut.
Okay, Tanya. This is your big scene. You're about to deep throat the hot dog, and you know how much I really want this scene to come true. You have been watching video after video, at least I hope you have been, because I sent over a dozen of them to you through YouTube, encrypted through your Gmail account. Now, if you don't get this straight, don't look at me like that. Don't look at me like that. I know you are a converted Catholic, and just because you are a little wary that your parents might see this, it doesn't matter. We are going to strike gold with this. Now, chug that dog. Action.
That's why we need to build an underground bunker! Come on, Coco Rin! Shake those Coco Buffs!
Is it too late to abort you?
Well, his parents are gonna be looking for him.
No, they're not! They're in Mexico, looking for something new!
You know he was a racist?
I remember the first time that I laid my eyes on you. My jaw was dropped straight to the ground while Mary.
I'm world sensation Sam Smith, and if that doesn't make your mouth water, this tingly drink will. Alright, cut.
And cut! Wait a minute. Cut? Cut, cut. Alex, why cut? You were doing so amazingly!
We don't even know what brand of soda we're selling, and secondly, I look nothing like Sam Smith. What the fuck?
All in moderation, buddy. This commercial is just to get some recognition from Mr. Polk. That way, when he recognizes us for our hard work, he can finally give us that $1 million budget and fund us for this project on the script that Rich left us when he went on his 3-month hiatus.
You mean the Bob Feller story?
Yep.
Wait, so you're actually taking an idea from Rich on a sports biopic?
So as long as we cast the movie well and 75% of the script is settled in World War II, I'm perfectly confident in the movie.
Yeah, that's a bit of a stretch, but... Okay. By the way, what happened to the understudy Rebecca? Wasn't she supposed to be here for the commercial?
Oh yeah, she's supposed to be here, holding a bottle of soda and whatnot, but due to a faulty snag in an operation that we were supposed to happen with...
Oh, that's what Rich was talking about. What the fuck? Tell me you didn't pay her to hold up a can of soda with a Roman candle in it.
Make a gasp, Alex! I would never commit Rebecca to do such a heinous crime!
Good.
I made her jump off the roof into a kiddie pool filled with the soda.
Please tell me.
She's in her own reserve hospital space at the ER. They know us all too well.
Alright. I'm gonna go get her a get well card.
Okay.
I'll see you later.
Well, what about our meeting with the general manager of Fundco?
As much as it pains me to say, you're flying solo on this one. But Rich told me Mr. Xavier's pretty dense, so just get his signature.
And if Funko is involved...
Vincent will no doubt hand over the budget. Don't screw this up, Tyler.
How could I screw this up?
So, let me get this straight. You would like my company to invest in your Bob Feller picture?
Yes, indeedy.
Well, Mr. Sebert, it's widely known that I'm a big Indians fan. And I think making a movie about Bob Feller would be an amazing thing. So, I'm in.
Great!
So, before I sign off on this deal, tell me, what is it that you're bringing to this picture that no other director possibly can?
Mr. Xavier, I too love Bob Feller! He was a history changer! Just to leave his men and go into World War II, my God, he was a phenomenal Indian! He broke barriers for the Navajos!
I see.
But Feller wasn't afraid to stand up against the Yellow Peril! Soon, with his brothers in arms, they were going to win the battle and return home to play in baseball! He would pick up that bat and hit home runs once more!
Bob Feller was a pitcher.
And a grinner! And a lover! And a picker! And a sinner!
Now you're just quoting lyrics from Steve Miller's The Joker.
And it was Bob Feller! Who ran into the offices of Mein Kampf and took out his trusty bow and arrow and ran over to Hitler and slew him down into his death with the final breaths of his famous catchphrase, I trust anyone but you, Kimusabi!
Question. Are you making a biopic or some kind of satirical spoof? Because that was pure gold.
Yes!
Alright, shake my hand, kid. We got a deal.
Alright!
So promise me everything you just said is gonna happen. Because if it doesn't, I'm gonna sue you.
Yep, yep!
Tyler, we are not rewriting this script as a satirical spoof with Bob Feller playing an Indian slaying Hitler. No!
We have to! Or else Xavier's gonna come and sue us!
Then tell him to release his name from the script.
You know how hard it was for Funko to even notice us at first?
Damn it, Tyler! Call Xavier now!
Maybe that's him right now.
Hopefully.
Shalom, you're speaking to Tyler.
You fat, cheeky bastard. Ah, Alex, it's for you.
No, put me on speaker. I want to talk to both of you.
You're already there.
Good. Because I'm about to say something that I never thought I would say to the two of you. Good job. I'm proud of you.
Say what?
Rich, do you have a cold or something? You're sounding less Rico Suave than usual.
Rich is on temporary leave. I'm Tyler's new temp, Alex Hill. Pleasure to meet you.
Ah, well then. God have mercy on your soul.
But Vincent...
First off, getting Funko to pay attention to us and back the film, that was a brilliant stroke, and honestly, I thought I was going to have one out of sheer joy. That's a huge fucking deal.
Tyler totally warped the script in front of Mr. Xavier.
And then you actually got Xavier Fund himself to sign the contract? Boys, girls, anybody who identifies as any other gender that they want, I'm amazed.
And now we have to shoot a shit movie.
Alex, you're killing my erection. Fuck off. Tyler, I'm sending you an extra $500 along with the already expansive budget I've wired you. Use that money strictly on hookers and blow.
Wow! Prostitutes and blow pops!
You know what? I'm so excited right now, even your extreme stupidity can't kill my buzz. And Alex?
Yes, Vincent?
I'm sending you a dollar. Go and shove it up your ass so you can shit money.
Why?
So you know what it's like to be rich, bitch! We're gonna make a fortune! As long as the movie gets made and Fun doesn't back out at the last minute, we're golden! Jody! Get in here! Polk out!
Well,
Vincent loves us.
This movie blows, I'm gonna kill you.
The only thing that's going to blow are my strippers. Come on. You wanna join me?
I do like strippers.
Yeah, everyone loves strippers.
So, I'm gonna be playing the Cleveland Indians manager.
Yeah.
Aren't I a little young to play that?
Well, I took some liberties. You see, in this script, the Cleveland Indians coach was actually a young and rowdy youngster who decided to inherit the team from his dying uncle, who was a boozer, who beat young children. But since the kid that you played was a boozer himself who got beaten up as a child, he decides to take the team and do everything himself. Now he would have to be abused himself.
Okay.
Now put your baseball cap on.
That hat, that's not even an Indian's hat. That's not even a baseball hat.
I'll fix it in post. Editing magic conquers all. Quiet on the set!
Tyler, there's no one here.
Action!
Listen, feller, I need you to dodge the draft. Now come over here and E-nay Chuck.
Cut, cut, cut!
How
do I say this to you without insulting you, but your voice isn't gruff enough.
Wow. Tyler, you just said I was a young hotshot.
Yeah, but nowadays, tons of young hotshots have gruff voices. I mean, look at Harrison Ford. To me, I know that acting isn't your expertise. You've always been behind the camera and writing scripts and everything, doing the budgets, but think of what your father would have wanted.
Why you gotta bring out my dad?
You mean Vincent's old partner who used to run Bug and Polk Industries until he was shot to death by Mr. Big and now you're all alone in the world? Flashback?
Yeah, that was my dad.
I loved your father, Timmy. Like he was my own dad. What a time we had when we went out on his boat together.
You accidentally blew up the garden, Tyler.
Julio fixed it up. Anyways, don't do this acting gig for me, but for Jerred, Timmy.
This is my dad, Tyler.
Flashback!
Sure.
Action! Thank you so much for coming in on such short notice.
No problem, man. It's a good thing you shoot this thing in sequence. Because if you didn't, I wouldn't be able to edit this thing within 3 hits of a blunt.
Well, it still looks good nonetheless, Stu.
And color correcting an actor's face to make him look Native American, that was not easy, man.
Well, I told Ronnie to do the scene, but he didn't want to wear the makeup because apparently even he has limits.
Actors these days, man. Back when I used to act, things were so much simpler. Slept on the floor, had one bathroom, ate one meal, did everything the director asked.
Well, that's the way it should be. My God, why'd you quit being an actor?
I fucking hated the working conditions.
At least you exchanged your trade for something just as talented. You really know how to edit, especially on a Windows Movie Maker.
Thanks, man. I mean, next year, I plan on upgrading to Adobe.
Oh, wow! Big bucks there!
Technically, man, I'm getting the off-brand version. My brother's buddy sells them out of the trunk of his car. It's called a Babel.
Wow! Big bucks there!
Hey, man, most important thing, their movies are gonna look gorgeous.
Yeah? Yeah, they will.
So, like, when are you gonna shoot the sequence where Bob's friend, Chipper, swallows the grenade?
We're planning on shooting that within a few weeks because Rich is currently junkyarding for a dummy.
What? I thought you guys had like a big budget or something.
We do have a large budget. We just spent more than we should have on expensive hookers. Little tip for ya. Never go into the shady part of town and gloat about having a large, expensive wad of cash in your pocket to a little hooker named Velvet Underbrush. She'll wring you dry.
Note taken.
You
You don't have a pen?
I don't need one, man. All right. This was a very productive day. Now I have to get to filming, so please take your editing system and continue editing, but you gotta do it somewhere else.
All right. Mr. Director.
Hello?
I know who you are. I know that Tyler Sebert is an enemy of yours. Believe me, he's an enemy of many.
Who are you?
I'm a man who wants Tyler Sebert and his entire crew out of the picture. Care to join me?
When do we begin?
Ah, shit. Now, people, this here is Desdemona Pepperpots. She was once Maurice Big's lover. Now that he's dead, she wants Tyler's head on a fence. Trouble's a brewing. And where's my coffee?
I have to tell you something, Mr. Polk. Your investment in these filmmakers really astound me.
Oh, really? How so?
I mean, look at all their other movies. They're garbage. Absolutely terrible. I've never seen such crap in my life.
Now, hold on. This is the part where I start blaming America. Where are you going? Hey, Mr. Tomato. Hold on. Mr. Tomato. Just one more thing. This is who she is. Or was. This is her.
Yeah, I get your point.
If I was you, I would have dropped him years ago. I don't know why, but you stuck with him, bomb after bomb after bomb.
Well, you know, I guess ingenuity gets you somewhere.
It did. It got you here. And when this film is released, you're gonna have companies scrambling to get your attention.
Oh, you're far too modest.
I'm too wise. This Sebert fellow has finally come through. The satire he put together has my sight in stitches.
Oh, mine too! Mine too!
I gotta go, Vincent. It's time for me to drive home and get some dinner.
Enjoy your succulent crab legs, Mr. Fun.
Please, call me Xavier. We're friends now, Vincent. Gotta go, ta-ta.
Jesus Christ, this guy might be a bigger idiot than Gerard was. Flashback.
Tyler, did you see the letter we got from Mr. Xavier today?
Oh, we got mail today?
Yeah, and judging by the demands, this film is in the shitter.
What?
Read for yourself.
He does want us to rewrite the entire script from scratch.
Shitter.
Okay, let's not overreact. Okay, look right there. At least he's sticking to the project. I mean, his signature is right there.
That's his thumbprint.
Thumbprint, signature, it's the exact same thing in the business world. All we gotta do is retool the script, and we're as good as gold.
Wait a minute. It says we have to send him the script through the mail. Why?
Right there. He explains that he just caught a bad case of the leprosy.
Ooh. Yeah. What if Polk finds out?
He'll be fine. He's as happy as a Pharrell song.
Are you sure?
Silence, Temp!
Tyler, this wasn't the character I played the other week.
No, this is a whole new character, and it's better.
This isn't a new movie, is it?
Yeah, it is. It's a better movie!
Hey, man. I studied up for that role. I studied baseball, and I even looked up that Bob Feller guy. And he wasn't even Native American. He didn't even run Mussolini over with a car.
Like I said, I took some liberties.
No, Tyler. All we do is lose actors, change scripts.
It wasn't my idea! It was our funder, Mr. Xavier!
Whoa, wait. Your funder changed the script?
Yeah! Come back!
So you actually went with the idea?
Sometimes you have to be a big boy, Timmy, and right now I'm wearing the big boy pants!
Okay.
We can't have another film doom itself. Polk finally trust me. It's like Gerard's still alive. Flashback. I don't want him to revert back into an evil mongoose!
Sorry, I lost you at mongoose.
It's a gerbil! Timmy, listen. Haven't you ever wanted to direct a film?
Yeah, recently.
Really?
Yeah, I would write it. Combs is gonna direct it.
I don't care.
Wow.
In the end, it's all about ambition! And our ambition is to get this movie done!
Tyler, is this, motivational speech gonna go anywhere?
Yes! Now! Get down on the ground and play clamp the impregnated uterus until your heart is going to burst!
I want a different role.
Leon, killing their funder didn't create any hurdles for them. They still completed a new script, and are continuing filming. I'm looking right at it. You and Desdemona, get in there and do some serious damage. Pronto.
And action! Cut! I'm sorry, Timmy, but that's just not how a sperm squirms. And pop goes the balloon!
What was that?
I don't know.
Let's go see.
Whoa! Stand back to me! There's glass all over the floor! It could be dangerous! You go first.
Why?
Z!
You're stupid. Tyler, do you hear that?
Yeah. That oddly specific beeping sound effect? Coming from? It's a bomb! Ducky, come out of my way! Ah!
Oh, laryngitis. Timmy! Timothy Bond! Where are you? Ah! Timmy! Timmy! No! Timmy! I'll save you!
Okay?
What are you throwing me?
Okay, you're awake. Good.
Dude, what happened?
Some neighborhood hoodlums threw a bomb through my basement window. I don't think I could ever go back in there.
Tyler, where are you going?
I forgot the camera! I have to thank you two so much for helping me out today.
I'd rather be doing this than acting in your stupid movie.
I can't believe we found duplicates of all my furniture.
Well, there it comes.
No problem. You just made me waste all my money on my credit card.
I owe you one, pal.
Yeah, you have to owe me
$15,000. Well, you're lucky the house is still standing.
Yeah, well, I bet the bomb was just cheap.
Are you still using this place as a set?
Well, I'm thinking about it, but I'm also going to do some location scouting just in case we need a backup set.
Yeah, Combs. You never know when someone's going to bomb your set.
Exactly.
Well, excuse me then.
I'll just put a call out and see if I can find a better place to film as Timmy's location.
Till then, watch your back.
Yeah, Ty. I don't want you getting hurt.
Nonsense! Who would want to hurt me?
Don't worry, Mr. Finetti. Unlike Leon, I know how to take out pests without using explosives.
I sent our two filmmaker wannabes a batch of my homemade poison, and let me tell you, it's pretty deadly. I can guarantee you, they won't be getting up from this one.
Oh my god! Is Timmy okay?
Yes, but the important thing is, the camera's okay.
Tyler, you both could have died.
Yes, we could have, but I did the adult thing and called the police and put out a report on the hoodlums who threw the bomb through the window.
I don't know, that sounds like an assassination attempt to me.
Well, yeah, either that or a bunch of angry decorative moms who were very upset at my wallpapering skills.
Where would they even get a bomb?
eBay, probably.
Great. Now we're down an actor.
Oh, no we're not! Timmy's still in great hopes!
Did you see the voicemail he left this morning?
I quit! I quit! I quit! I quit.
Oh, that Timmy! Always a Juilliard professional!
Where did you get that sandwich?
Catering brought it up.
We don't have catering.
Alex, now's not the time to be talking about that kind of schmuckety. Now's the time to be feasting upon these nummy, nummy treats.
Do you smell iodine?
Now that you mention it.
Tyler! No!
I need to hire a caterer so we can fire that son of a bitch!
What the fuck?
Yeah. Apparently, Tyler was rushed to the hospital. He was poisoned by some kind of mysterious sandwich. Damn it. I'm out of milk.
Poisoned? What do you mean poisoned? Like food poisoning?
Not exactly. The doctor pumped his stomach, and there was some sort of illegal shit lining his stomach.
Jesus!
Got him there just in the nick of time. Awesome, it's fat-free too.
Well, at least he didn't swallow some illegal drugs, mistaking them for his Flintstone vitamins again.
Polk, this is pretty serious. First, someone tries to burn down Tyler's house. Now, mysterious sandwiches are poisoning people.
You know, you're actually right. That is weird.
Do we know of anyone that would want to shut our production down? I mean, besides Disney?
Well, let me see. Mr. Big is dead, and Patrick Huff, Tyler's indie filmmaker rival, is also dead.
Why is there a body in there?
Well, to answer the first question, I think that might be
Patrick Huff.
Yeah. A lot of death follows us around, I see.
I'll give you a call back, Stu. I've got a couple of things I need to check out. But make sure that filming keeps going.
What about Tyler?
Hey, if Elton John can go on with the show after getting a gallon of semen pumped from his stomach.
Okay, okay. Jeez, I get it.
Good. Polk out.
Hello. You've reached Xavier Fund's personal answering machine. Not here at the moment, but if you'd like to leave a message, please do so. I'll call you back as soon as I return. And be sure to leave your name and number so I know who to call. Thank you.
Also weird. Couldn't be.
Yes. You reached Carmen Fernetti.
Fernetti. Polk.
Vincent! I was on the verge of thinking we weren't speaking to each other any longer.
As was I.
What can I do you for?
I have a question to ask you.
Go ahead and shoot.
Oh, believe me, I wish I could. Now be honest with me, are you fucking with my crew?
Vincent, excuse me?
Oh, I'm sorry, do you need me to slow it down for you? Are you fucking with
my crew!
Vincent, I read the newspaper just like every other person in this world. I shit on the toilet and need a little reading material. I've seen what's happening to your film crew. Terrible stuff.
Yeah, it's a fucking tragedy.
But for you to think I'm behind all of this? I'm insulted.
Oh, and I'm insulted that somebody thinks they can actually get away with fucking with me. So let me tell you what's gonna happen, Mr. Conglomerate Asshole. If I find out that you're involved in this, I'm gonna send somebody down there with the 16th century pike I keep on my office wall. He's gonna shove it sideways, up your ass, burn your house down, and then put a bullet in your fucking skull just for a good measure.
Is that a threat, Vincent? Because as you know, threats this serious are quite illegal.
I hate you, Fernetti. I've always hated you, even back in boarding school. You stole every girl that ever showed the slightest bit of interest in me. You cheated off my test so you could pass. And if you think I've forgotten about the dreaded crotch-worthy towel snap, you've got another thing coming. You, sir, are a fucking loser.
And yet here I sit, still more successful than you are.
If you are behind this...
Vincent, I'm not.
You're a dead man.
Now we can let the real fun begin. Just hope I remember to press play on the recorder.
Thanks for waiting for me, man.
Yeah.
I was drenching up in there. The poison is still hitting me pretty hard.
Yeah, no problem, bro.
So how's everything coming along on the birthing scene?
Man, great. Actually, I made the placenta really pink, just as you requested.
Good.
And let me tell you, that was no easy feat. Had to go with at least through 6 blunts.
Well, when you are using jelly as a practical effect, you have to spare the corners and put your trust in a good editor.
Yeah, now watch as I... Whoa.
What?
Look at your TV, man. Look at the breaking story.
Holy mama.
Special report. Famed indie film producer Vincent Polk was arrested today on charges of threatening behavior.
What?
Polk had called fellow businessman Carmen Fernetti and threatened to shoot him in the head as well as burn his house down. Why? According to Fernetti, it was because Polk was jealous of his success. When asked about the felony, Polk had this to say.
This is a setup! I've been made a patsy! Johnny!
Oh, how the mighty have fallen. Up next, Kylie Jenner wants to become a man.
Weed got legalized! Woo!
He just got arrested!
Who gives a shit? Free weed, man!
It's not free! It's still illegal! When did I become the sensible one?
Free weed! Blazer! 420! Every day!
I can't believe it!
Wait a minute. I was on the phone with him just a couple days ago. He said he had a few calls to make.
Vincent would never make a threat this brash unless he really meant it.
What could this, like, Carmen Spaghetti Fernetti guy do to piss off Vincent so much?
I don't know, but I'm gonna have to find out.
You go do that.
I'll go call Rich. Thanks, Stu.
Yeah, no problem. Now, gotta go take a shit. I'm gonna need a bigger blunt. Fuck.
Apparently, Carmen Fernetti is a giant business conglomerate.
And his connection to Polk?
Fernetti likes to buy up smaller industries, such as Polk's, and make them his own.
Does this mean everything that Fernetti has done has been one giant ploy to try to get Vincent to sign away Polk and just be Damon Industries?
It could be. The fire, the poisoning, and Vincent.
But why take us out?
Think about it. What does this guy have that he doesn't.
Pants.
Tyler, why are you wearing pants?
I'm so cold.
No, us. With us out of the picture, Vincent would have no other choice but to sell.
Right.
We need to prove to the world that this Fernetti guy is behind the whole thing.
Right.
Send me undercover.
Right. Do it for America.
Hi.
Who are you? I'm Alex. Yeah, Rich, the original camera guy, was on leave, so the indie crew sent me in.
But I'm Rich.
Well, hey, I'm Alex.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. I'm gonna use the bathroom real quick.
Have a bet.
Tyler, who is that person that just left?
Rich! Oh my God, 3 months without you and I've been going through bombings, poisonings, all these Fernetti evilnesses! Where have you been?
I told you 3 months ago I had to plan for my grandfather's funeral, which was last week, you know?
I don't care! Dig a hole, put him in the ground! I need you now!
My grandfather was my inspiration for why I started filmmaking.
And I wasn't!
Tyler, you really gotta understand that there are other people outside of you that inspire people.
Well, nonetheless, it's good to have you back. Have you checked up everything on Vincent and...
Yeah, I heard the news. Fernetti's a bastard.
Yeah, he is. 1 second. Oh. Shit!
What?
Get on the computer, quick!
Why?
Stu just texted me! You gotta check out Polk's main website!
What for?
Someone is auctioning off Polk's main industry!
Wait, what? How is this even possible?
CrookedAuctions.com is currently selling it off, and within 30 seconds it's willing to go to the highest bidder.
Without Polk, he can't even buy his own industry back.
But maybe we can.
What?
We have a high enough budget!
That's for the movie!
This is for Vincent! We need to save the company or we won't be able to make any more movies together!
You're right. Okay, I'm logged in as Yellow Kraken.
Bid $1 million!
Don't you think this is a bit much?
Rich!
Fine.
Besides, if Fernetti doesn't buy the company, imagine how easy it would be for him to buy it off of some meager little company.
Yeah, okay.
Did you put the bid in yet?
Yes, I already did.
Good.
Shit.
What?
Bidding just went up to $30 million and we only have 12, 7, almost 10 seconds left now.
Oh my God, my EBS skills have to come in handy.
What do you suggest?
Snipe them. Snipe them with our whole budget.
But that's almost $50 million.
I don't care. This is for Polk.
But
it's not for Polk's ass, Rich! It's for Polk! Now do it! 3 seconds left!
Fine!
Did we win?
Yes!
Yes! Whoa!
You know what that means?
What?
We are now the sole owners of Polk and Just Me Damn Industries!
Take that, Fernetti!
Do with the movie?
We'll just make it on the cheap. Xavier won't notice.
I guess. I mean, we'll just switch on and off between filming and proving that Fernetti's a backstabbing fraud.
Hell yeah!
Yeah! Give me five!
Woo!
So you bought Polk's company?
Yep. You are now looking at one of the co-owners of Polk and Just Me Damn Industries.
I can always see a train wreck come out of this.
Vincent's gonna kill you.
Earth to Combs, Vincent is in jail getting 3 meals of squares.
That doesn't mean he's not innocent.
He'll get out one day and hunt you down, doofus.
Correction. He'll get out and hunt Rich down and then mutilate his soul.
Am I getting dumber?
Yes, I blame Tyler.
Hello? Why, yes, this is Tyler Sebert. Ah, you're answering my scouting search. I'll be back, you two little onions.
Do you think that poison went straight to his brain?
I think so.
Don't worry, Rich. I'm just going on some location scouting is all. Yeah, I got a call from a very nice lady who lives in the ghetto, and she has an apartment that she thinks will be wonderful as a replacement for Timmy's apartment. Yeah, and if we're lucky, that will be our new set. Yeah, she said her name was Izzy on the phone, but she sounded amazing. But, I really hope she understands that the Bob Feller story I showed her earlier is a completely new script now. But hey, that's the movie industry. Oh, I gotta go. I'm pulling in. Bye.
Something about this place seems awfully amiss. I just can't place my finger on it. Oh well. Let me just ring the doorbell. I sure hope she's home. I mean, she couldn't have just left the door unlocked for me. Huh. Nice place.
Hello? I'm here! Greatest indie filmmaker in the entire world and now company owner, Tyler Sebert!
Wonderful, wonderful. Please, have a seat. I'm just putting on my face, Pookie.
Something smells like iodine.
Why, hello, baby. My name's Izzy. Izzy Bloom. Welcome to my humble apartment.
Tyler Sebert, man, thanks for giving me the call. Woo! This is a beautiful apartment. Gorgeous.
Well, thank you, child. Let me swear my manners. Would you like something to drink?
Sure! So, Izzy, are you married?
I had a boyfriend named Desmond, but sadly we broke up over sentimental issues.
Oh, that sucks. And you're a dentist.
It's okay, fruitcake.
I hate to ask this, but do you smell the overwafting presence of iodine?
Not at all. Why do you ask?
I just can't help it, but hot. It just seems to be overcoming me.
Then that may be the air freshener. You know how Sears is always coming up with new scents. Here's your drink, Buttercup.
All right. Goody. I'm gonna savor this. Ah, that was spectacular. What was that?
Water.
Ah.
But it was my own special brew of water.
Oh.
I made it special. Just for you, boo-boo.
How? So.
What's wrong, honey? Sleepy?
No. Just a little sleepy is all.
Flashback.
You smell iodine?
It was you.
Sancta Ballerina!
You finally awake?
What's going on here?
You don't remember me, do you? You're dumber than you look.
My God! You don't want your apartment in my movie, do you?
I'm Desdemona Pepperpot's dummy. Longtime blaxploitation actress and girlfriend to Maurice Big.
No! No! Snap! Snap! Snap!
You thought you got rid of me, didn't you?
I thought I blew you and your friend Apple up!
Correction. You blew Desmond and Apple up.
I knew I should have used that coupon and gotten my glasses checked!
Now I can get my revenge on you for killing my man.
Wait! Can't we settle this on a trade of sorts?
Sure. Your life for my revenge.
That's not exactly what I was going for.
There's no way out of this, filmmaker. In the end, I win.
Dear Lord in heaven, when I am about to meet you at the pearly gates, please give me a seat next to Harpo Marx so I can finally know what his voice sounds like.
Could be Rich. If I don't answer the phone, he may get suspicious and put a search warrant out on me.
Fine. But one word about your situation, and I slit your throat. Deal?
Yes. Hello, you're speaking to Tyler.
Tyler, Vincent Polk.
Hello, what?
Look, I don't have a lot of time to talk. I'm on house arrest, and I've been drinking. So what I need you to do is to head over there and get a confession out of Carmen Fernetti.
10 more seconds before I hang up, idiot.
Get the confession and then do me a favor, will you?
What's that?
Kill the bastard.
Illegal, but right.
And don't ruin my company.
Time's up. Now how should I kill you? The poison didn't work. So maybe I'll stab you.
Nobody has to die today! Except for the bad guys! Oh shit! Slow motion leap!
Come out here and face me like the coward you are!
That's easy for you to say, you had the gun! Strategically placed weapon!
You were always pathetic, Sebert. Just like your films.
How about a taste of your own medicine?
Killed by Desdemona Pepperpots. You remember her, but I killed her now, finally. And Vincent called me. He says we need to get a confession out of Fernetti and pick up any other crew member. We're all in danger. I feel a storm is brewing. Quick, get us all together now. We're all in danger. And I think I left the washer running.
Come on. Stop. Glitching, you stupid editing program. Hello?
Stu!
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Get over to my house now!
Come on, man. I'm like in the middle of editing.
This is a life or death situation!
Dude, what, seriously?
Yeah, I was just attacked by a failed blaxploitation actress!
You're lucky, dog.
And I can't risk the loss of any other members of my crew! Now get over to my house, the set, pronto!
I'll be there as soon as the sequence renders.
How long would that take?
Like 3 minutes, at tops.
Any longer and I'm gonna be mega pissed! Get out of the road, I'm
celebrating!
Didn't even say goodbye, freaking dickhole director. Come on. I'd rather be shot than go through this kind of torture.
Ah! Fucking hell! Fuck!
Fucking hand! Ah, come on, somebody help! This isn't fun, I'm coming off of my high!
Rich! Rich, my god, Rich!
I just got your text, now what's going on?
Your text? I called you 15 times! Where's everybody else?
Well, no one showed up yet.
No one? What about Stu? He only lives 5 minutes down the block.
Actually, he hasn't shown up either.
My god, something's not right. I'll be back!
Wait, where are you going?
To find our editor! He's the best thing we got right now! He won a BIFF!
That's not even a real award, Tyler!
I went over to his house, looked everywhere for him.
I even got a contact high, but sadly, he wasn't there.
I guess Fernetti got to him, so I guess we're screwed. Stu! Stuart! Stuart, dear fellow, speak to me! It's okay, dear friend. Save your breath.
You're healing on my spleen.
Oh! Sorry. Who did this to you?
It was a sniper.
Damn Call of Duty experts!
No, it was an actual sniper. You know, with a gun and a bullet.
Oh, wow, that's messed up. Shit.
I know, right? Like, what the fuck? He shot me in my editing hand. My precious, precious editing hand.
Ooh.
And he stabbed me in the shoulder, but I'm all worried about my editing hand!
Ouch!
And my weed! But he kept me alive to give you a message.
What's the message?
Leon Big. Leon Big is coming for you.
Oh no.
And he doesn't fuck around.
Thanks, Stu. High five! Everything's gonna be okay. Rich! Rich! We're in some deep shit, Rich!
Called to the ER would be nice, Tyler. Dick.
Leon Big. Let me repeat that. Leon Big.
That's the name Stu gave me. He mentioned a Leon Big.
Oh, that's just fucking great. First Big's ex-girlfriend and now his little brother. Fucking A.
Little brother?
Yeah. Big's little brother, Leon, he got sent up by the feds a few years ago on some drug charges or some shit like that, and he was supposed to be gone for life. But I guess he got out early. Oh, and by the way, nice to have you back, Richard. That temp was starting to really chafe my ass.
How did he find out about us?
We made a biopic about us fighting his older brother.
Biopic?
We made a movie about us fighting his older brother.
But that never had a DVD release outside of Finland.
What?
Yeah, I'd never tell you this if I was completely sober, Tyler, but basically I blew a couple $1 million to make sure that your film never gets manufactured by any DVD maker in this entire country. You're welcome.
Could Desdemona and Big be hired by Fernetti?
Oh, you think that could have happened, do you? Well, gee, ask for brains. I'm sure that it happened. I'd bet my dick on it.
Yeah, well, it doesn't matter, Rich, because even though Fernetti hired two assassins, I was able to take out one of them, so I could definitely take out two of them.
Well, I don't know about that. I mean, yeah, Desdemona was an actress, but Leon Big? He's a certified killer, just like his older brother. And you know, remember how well that went?
Flashback.
You know, this is one of the reasons I'm glad Rich is back, Tyler, because he's right. You're in over your head.
As co-owner of Sebert, Cornell, and Polk Industries.
You changed the fucking... Why am I in third place? I'm the senior partner here.
Just for now until I sell it back to you.
Sell it back? Sell it back?
Well, I think Tyler's trying to get at is... what are you trying to get at, Tyler?
What I'm trying to say is that we are independent filmmakers, and we can't let petty criminals or stuffy-nosed conglomerates get us down. We love making this kind of art. We will never let these people put us down, no matter who they are, how big they are, and how corporate they are. We will never bow down before their money, their evil power, or their sorcery. We are independent filmmakers, artists, and overall, dreamers. We love what we do, and we do it for ourselves. And that will never change.
Well, that was actually truly beautiful there.
Thank you.
Do I have to get the fucking pike?
Then I humbly stick up my middle finger and blow my ass at him!
Well, back to normal. Okay, Tyler, what do you suggest?
I suggest we do what Polk suggested we do. March up to Carmen Fernetti, knock on his door, pick up a recorder, record a confession out of him, and wallop him to kingdom come!
Right, because, you know, solving violence with more violence just fixes everything.
Rich, you're killing my erection. Shut the fuck up. He's got it coming to him.
Rich, we need to arm ourselves. Do you still have those weapons for when we scare off the Girl Scouts?
You use them for what?
Nothing.
Don't ask. So what'd you pick?
I'll take the cannon.
Really?
Yeah. I'm always ready.
God help us all. Actually, why should I?
Question. What if he decides to nuke the entire house?
Rich! For Nettywood! That's actually a very good point.
I'm going to the restroom.
Remember to put the silencer on when you use the potty! Weird. Leon Big, I presume. Rich, I need your help out here! Yeah, don't touch. Now, if you could be so kind. I love surprises. Just not right now. You can't be Leon Big because, one, you look just like me, and two, you have the total opposite color skin of Leon Big.
Let's just say while I was down in the inner cells of my containment, I had a personal friend. Turn my face into my enemies. I based it off of a DVD I got out of Finland.
Leon Big, please! I am incredibly sorry about what happened between your brother and I. What happened was a colossal misunderstanding.
You're damn right.
Can't we just hug this out?
Oh, Leon Big, don't hug. That's soft shit.
Oh. Then I guess you can just
shoot you.
Bring a spare weapon.
that decoy gun technique was really spot on. And his bulletproof vest I got really came in on check. I borrowed it from your dad's war closet. You sit there calmly while I go deal with Fernetti. I'll be back. Why did I buy that ramp if it doesn't make me look badass?
Now, this is usually the moment where the audience would stand up and cheer for our hero. But sadly, our hero is a dumbass who thinks blue is a vegetable. I'm off to go buy him a nice burial plot. How does this sound? Here lies Tyler Sebert. May he ride the pony in infamy. Yep. Sounds fine. Nailed it. Now, where's my coffee?
Hey, Pamela, you can go home early. I won't be needing you. Let's just say my next meeting will be quick and painless. Thank you, darling. Ah, right on time. I appreciate a punctual appointment. Have you come to offer me a role in your next movie?
Not exactly.
Welcome to Fernetti Enterprises, Mr. Sebert.
Murderer!
Excuse me?
I know your game, Fernetti. You send Leon, Big, and Desdemona over to kill me and Rich. But we do what we do good and well.
And what exactly is it that you two do?
We get even!
By butchering humans and making craptastic movies. I see.
You set Vincent up.
Tyler, you just don't understand how the world works.
And how does the world work in your eyes, Carmen?
Independent art isn't really art. It's a pimple. It's a skid. It's a piece of poo.
Independent art speaks volumes.
It speaks nothing. It's garbage. It's trash.
You know what? It's bigwigs like you who think they can buy off all the little people and go off and do whatever they want. They don't give a shit about the people like us. But we do what we want to do and create beautiful pieces of art. And that's something important. And you can never take that away.
Hey, I know what to do what's right.
No, you know what to do what's wrong.
Tyler, when I sent those two thugs after you, I simply was trying to reclaim what was mine.
Vincent's company.
But he refused to give it to me.
So you edited some of his rant towards you to make it look like he was going to kill you, and you sent that to the police.
It's amazing what a little editing magic can do. And with him out of the way, I was going to buy the studio. But
Rich and I got in the way.
And I was so sure burning your house down and poisoning your food would shut down production. Hell, even having Leon kill your guest butler so you had to change the script didn't change anything.
Well, you thought, wait, you killed Xavier?
Besides that point, you filmmaker wannabes are just a damn nuisance. Join me. We can stop independent art and you will finally be the director you've always wanted to be.
Thanks, bud. No, thanks.
You've been filming this whole conversation?
Not so dumb, am I?
You little... You're gonna regret coming here. I am the future of art. I am the lord of all that is wealth. I am Carmen Fernetti!
Hey, Oswald? It's Rich. Yeah, I know I'm back. Hey, how are the pyrotechnics going for that final scene? Yeah? Well, did you do any tests for them yet? No? Okay, good. I need you to fire all of them.
Just a little. Not fair.
I need you to fire off every Roman candle, every warhead, every M80. Hell, even fire the sparklers. I don't give a shit.
Whoa! Don't I get a timeout or something?
Sorry. Didn't hear the bell.
What do you mean? I don't care if it's illegal. This is for both Tyler's life and the sake of indie art everywhere.
Just give me the camera.
You know, I really don't want to, despite the horrible pain running through my body.
I know that all the fireworks will set off the building in Carmen Fernetti's building. You know what? Just shoot them all off. You have 5 minutes to do so. No, the cops are not going to notice. Now do it! Just make sure the head never grows back. We have to take out the entire body.
Breaking my heart, kid. It's like I'm fighting a cripple.
What's wrong, Fernetti? You sound like you're actually growing a heart.
Fine.
Messed with the wrong filmmaker.
Like I haven't heard that before.
It's for you.
Hello?
No, giving you a call. Just making sure that I'm alive and not making a distraction at all. You know, just allowing Tyler to do something deadly.
This is for the costumers who put out of business! The set designers! Every filmmaker who wanted more in the world!
Most importantly, this is for Vincent.
Holy shit, Tyler! Oh god, those are my new shoes I let you borrow, weren't they? Tyler? Hey, it's me, Rich. You can see me down here. You need to get out of that building right now. I just ordered Oswald to fire all of our pyro at that building, and from the sound of it, they're firing off right now, so get out of there.
Time to Vin Diesel this shit!
So...
Yes?
I guess I can say this now that you've both cleared my name.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
I'm just glad I'm not under house arrest anymore. There's only so much daytime TV a man can take.
Now, I can't believe the media's still been abuzz about Fernetti being the villain in all this. They've been playing the footage 24/7 the past few weeks.
So what did the police say when they went to the remnants of his burned-down building?
They just blamed it on global warming.
Okay, that's logical for a given value of logic. Anyway, whatever happened to your temp? Last I heard, you were sending him undercover.
Fernetti sucker punched him and threw him in prison. Rich is on his way to bail him out right now.
Of course you did.
And now, Vincent, with you back in action, Rich and I would humbly like to hand over the leadership of the company Polk and Just Me Damn Industries.
As you damn well should.
On one condition.
Okay.
When Fernetti died, so did all those little companies he bought up. I want you to breathe life back into all those little companies he bought up and destroyed.
Why the hell would I do that? Because if I owned all these little companies, I could be a...
dream killer. Just like Carmen Fernetti was. Give these industries back to the little people, Vincent. Keep indie art alive.
All right.
Then you have a deal. I'll send the documents of every industry Fernetti ever bought up through the mail within a week.
Yeah. Hugs, kisses, friendship is magic, all that bullshit. Just remember that you owe me and Fund a movie within the next 3 months.
Yeah, about that.
Oh, what now?
Rich is late again! I can't believe this! I can't believe this! Of all the days he's gonna be late, he's gonna be late on the first day of shooting of the script he handed me of his Sailor Moon movie! And I trusted him! I trusted him! I said, buddy, this is the best script you ever showed me! I actually read it, believe it or not! Now... oh. You got a flat tire. Okay. I guess I can start shooting without him a little bit. All right, everybody, roll call. I am Tyler Sieber, your director, our writer, and cameraman. Rich Cornell is going to be a little late today. Our new co-cameraman and jib operator is currently using the restroom.
Whoa, that guy!
Oh, I should have told the police about Leon's body instead of just throwing it into the bathroom. Timmy, you're looking over the promotional stuff. That's great. Combs and Selena, keep painting the set. Stu, keep editing. And, where's Rebecca? Oh, yeah, I gave her the day off because she couldn't pronounce the word anime. All right, this looks great. Tanya, I gave you that short skirt and that push-up bra because remember, this is an anime. Action!
My, my, my. How could we have ever doubted these individuals? Surely we knew they would rise above the craft and skill level to save the day and, yeah, this is bullshit. Now let's just rip off Animal House and see where they all ended up, shall we? Tyler Sebert went on to direct several other films with his friend and cameraman, Richard Cornell, until they had a falling out over who was more visionary of the two. Tyler eventually delved into porn and directed over 200 short films in the span of 5 months with the company Ball and Gag Studios. He even started one with Ron Jeremy. Tyler currently resides in South Carolina with his puppy, Paco. Richard Cornell, after splitting apart from Tyler, went on to become a boom mic operator on several big Hollywood films. He got a gig as a director on some Hunger Games knockoff films, which led him to direct Dwayne Johnson in some big league action films. Ironically, Rich won 5 Oscars, and as his future progressed, he became good friends with fellow directors Quentin Tarantino and Kevin Smith. Richard is currently writing his first major Hollywood screenplay, a documentary called How I Started Off in the Indie Industry. Vincent Polk eventually quit the indie film scene and went on to do what he called political justice. He started his own political party called the Dammit Party. He even ran for president in 2016. His slogan was, "Terrorists, get the fuck out." He didn't exactly go that far. Vincent Polk eventually retired from politics and went into television broadcasting with his bride-to-be Judy. They currently reside in Las Vegas, where if you visit them, they will automatically cast you in one of their 12 reality shows. Timmy Bug took over Polk and Just Mint Dammit Industries in honor of his late father, Gerard Bug. Flashback. He changed his name back to Bug Industries, where he promised to produce nothing but independent art for the masses. And that's about it. Yeah, it's kind of a boring outcome. He currently resides in Columbus, Ohio, and, hey, could be worse. Good living Cleveland. Stu Blemmer continued to work with Tyler and Rich until he went to go buy a cheap, watered-down version of Adobe. When he arrived at the pickup scene, he discovered a drug heist was going on right next door, and a shootout occurred. He was fatally wounded and died within a matter of hours. He currently resides at Washington State Cemetery, third plot from the left, and it's Scott Haber.
Mr. Narrator? None of that stuff has happened yet.
Huh?
I'm just pointing out the fact that none of that stuff has happened yet.
Are you sassing me?
I'm not trying to alarm you in any fashion. I'm just saying the truth. I mean, let's look at the facts. I mean, Timmy is in high school. Stu is alive and well. I mean, Ron Jeremy has a restraining order against me, even.
Well, pardon me for having a little fun, you bastards.
But then again, what if this is a look into the future? I can trade Rich's career with my career. Hey, Rich! Do you want to trade an Oscar for a dick?
See that? Even when you have a little fun with these people, it all gets blown out of proportion. I'm Morgan Freeman, and these were a bunch of idiotic filmmakers who somehow cheated death and prison sentences. Otherwise known as the Filmmaker Wannabes. Now where's my check? Make it rain, bitches. Make it rain.
Now, Vincent called me. He says we gotta get a confession out of Fernetti, but he's on his way to kill all of us in the rear. Fuck. I'm keeping the first one.
And gotta wait for that noise in the background. Dad is like doing some kind of water effects back there.
Hell yeah, I won! That decoy gun technique really did the trick! And this makeshift bulletproof vest. Oh, fuck. Yes! Yes!
Vincent's merely that Vincent's excited about it, but then he finds fun to be just as much of an idiot as Gerard Bug was.
once more.
I think I missed something.
No, it was good. It was good. Let's do it once more.
Okay.
A little bit more over.
I can guarantee you, they won't be getting up from this one.
You stepped on something, yeah. Blooper.
This is Tony's head that I am currently creating.
Speeding.
Over wall, over speed.
Speeding.
Yeah. Okay. Setting up shot for Tony's demise, the head smashing scene.
The bomb.
You did a bomb me!
Once more, because I could hear Alyssa with a script.
Come on!
Immense operation, Ivanovsky.
I look like the love child of Fred Savage from Austin Powers and Drew Carey.
There's no way out of this, filmmaker. In the end, I wait.
Alright, that's it for this one. I gotta do a costume change.
What?!
We'll have the bitty off!
I remember when he took me out on his boat.
Where are you? Accidentally. We left the garden, yeah. Can we do that once more? Because you jumped over my head.
And what exactly is it that you do?
I'm sorry, Timmy, but that's just not how a sperm squirms.
Tyler, it's Rich. You need to get out of that building, right?
Yeah. Okay. It's okay. You're looking around like the car is not starting. You want to do that once more?
It's a long one.
It is. We could do it again, though, if you want.
You
want
to do that once more because you kind of slurred one line?
Yeah, but technically.
Yeah. We're as good as gold.
Shitter.
Oh, shoot. Slow motion leap! Oh, shoot.
Yak Holmes.
Action.
Pain's been to say you're flying solo on this one. But Rich told me Xavier's pretty dense, so we need his company's signature and his support if we want to.
So close. And
who was that motherfucker?
You know what? I'm so ecstatic right now. Even your moron, even.
Yeah, I got a call from a very nice lady who lives in the ghetto and said she would like us to look.
Come back!
No!
Well, you're gonna have to come back. That's not how it ends.
Yeah, Rich got him here just at the nick of time.
There.
Got him there?
Yeah, got him there.
No!
Yes, take two, final time.
Are we gonna do it now?
Either, probably.
Amazon? Probably. GoFundMe?
And look at it very angry and then say the line. I killed it. We sprayed it with, like, air freshener. And then we killed it.
You would like my company to invest in your Bob Fuller picture.
You want to do that once more because you said Fuller? Bob Feller.
You and Desdemona get there and do some suit out of the
Yeah.
This is...
Thing. I know Fun's got the last line before he gets shot, but I thought of this and you might find it funny. I don't know, use it or not.
Why? It's to save Tyler's life in the indie art film.
Okay, cut.
And if you think I've forgotten about the dreaded crotch-worthy towel snap, you can forget it. That's stupid. That was a dumb line that was redundant. Let's try that again.
Our writer and cameraman, Chris Cornell.
Chris Cornell.
That this guy doesn't. Us.
Cut right there, because there's a joke we gotta add in.
Okay. And action.
Alright.
We gotta wait for your mom.
Oh. I know, this is...
Let me see that.
She's emptying out the water, folks. Stand back to me! This glass will look...
Oh, sorry, it took too long. I wanted to make sure we were in frame.
Killing their funder didn't create any hurdles for them. They will this is hard. It is hard.
Let's stay on that angle. Cut for a second, because there was something.
Never even ran listening to those cars.
You want to do that once more?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Okay.
Not fair. Good.
Yeah. Should I keep it there?
No, that was good. No.
Okay.
There we go.
Amazing.
Did it backwards, but...
It's okay, it still works. I love it. Okay, let me cut.
Look at Harrison Ford.
You're right.
Let's do that once more, but without you going...
Okay. I like that sound effect either.
Yeah.
Oh, no. I've read on people...
This is for the customers you put out of business! This is for... Sorry.
Oh, I'm here, Dad.
Sorry.
It's two.
Okay, three, two. Okay. Okay. Sorry if I scare you.
I came into the studio and everybody wanted me to record something. I'm here for the part of the narrator. Tyler Sebert. Yeah, I heard of the guy. Made one of my favorite documentaries. El Tomato. It's a riveting picture.